You just cannot say a word for life for you. Catastrophe. And Judah's just like, I'll wait for you. Which I don't know why, whenever the phrase like, I'll wait for you comes up in a book, I swear it every single time. Hello, welcome to the channel, I hope you're doing well. So for today's video, I thought I would do the video that I've seen quite a lot of people do, where I read the highest rated book on Goodreads versus the lowest rated book on Goodreads that I own like physically. Now, I've seen quite a few people do this, so I thought I would try doing it myself, considering there's a book I want to read, and it ended up being the highest book on my Goodreads, so I thought this is the right time to do this video. There was a few books that was quite close as well to the rating of the book that I'm going to read in this video, which I'll show you soon. We did have A Court of Wings and Ruin, which is the third book in the ACOTAR series, which I believe was like a 4.4 something on Goodreads, as well as Long Way Down, which is again a 4.47, I think. But I'm kind of glad that I'm not going into any of them, because Long Way Down, I've kind of just put that book off in the Editor's Choice series for a while, and also A Court of Wings and Ruin, I'm just not very in my fancy era at the moment. The book that is the highest rated that I have on Goodreads is This Could Be Yours by Kenny D. Ryan. Now, this book literally came out about 3 days ago, and it's already on like a 4.56, and I don't really think that's gonna change, because Before I Let Go by her is very high rated as well on Goodreads. I think I gave that one like a 4.5 stars. I loved it. I initially gave it like a 5 star, and then I kind of put it down to a 4.5 star, but still one of my favorite reads from last year. So I'm very excited to go into this book. I read the blurb and I just know this is going to be quite emotional. I think the FMC is like trying to find herself, so I'll read the blurb so you guys kind of know what this book is about. So this follows Soledad, who is the best friend of Yasmin in the first book. So it says Soledad Barnes has her life all planned out. She plans everything, she designs everything. Why have I got, I thought there was like a stain on it, it's fine, it's just a bit fluff. She fixes everything, but none of her varied talents can save her when I try to read blurbs and then I can never say the words. But none of her very talents can save her when catastrophe strikes, and the life she built with a man who was supposed to be her forever disappears in a cloud of betrayal and disillusion. There's no time to pout or even grieve the life she lost. She's too busy looking after her daughters, and in the process of saving them all, Soledad rediscovers herself. Then an unlikely man enters the picture, the one she shouldn't want but can't seem to resist. She's lost it all before and refuses to repeat her mistakes. Can she trust him? Can she trust herself? After all she's lost and found, can she be brave enough to make room for what could be? That sounds very good. I'm excited to read this book, because I love the first book. I love the cover. I don't know what Kenny D. Ryan does with the covers, but they're always like one of the prettiest covers. So I'm excited. I have very high expectations for this book. If it's anything lower than a 4-star, I'm not going to be happy. So I'm going to read that one first, and then we're going to go into the lowest rated book afterwards. I think people do like lowest rated first and highest rated. I'm not sure, does it matter which way you're doing it? I'm doing highest rated first and then lowest rated, because I'm so excited to read this book. The lowest rated book I have is Mr. Hockey by Leah Riley. Now this one is one that I picked up from the works through the day, and I think it's got like a 3.32 rating on Goodreads. There's three books in this series, but all of them are kind of novella length. Like this is literally less than 200 pages, 194 pages. These are the two books I'm going to read. I'm going to start This Could Be Yours now, because I'm starting this a little bit later on Friday. That's the fact I'm late in. It's currently nearly 4 o'clock. It might already be 4 o'clock, so it's quite late. I've got a headache because I've been out all day. I don't know why. If I'm out all day, I get headaches. Is that normal? I'm not sure. So we're going to start the Kenny D. Ryan book now, and I'll give you an update later on. Hi guys, so it's quite a little bit later on now. It's currently about 8 o'clock. I have only read like 60 pages of my book. I can't read any tonight because I need to like have a bath, do my hair, and all that type of thing, which always takes me like 2 hours to do. So I won't be able to read much today. I'm not going to show you the book because the lighting whenever I hold it up gets affected and gets so bright. So I'm just going to set the picture here. But this book, so far, as I said, I'm only 60 pages in, but I'm really enjoying it. So it's about Soledad, who's the best friend of Yasmin in the first book, and Judah. Soledad has been married to her husband, I think she said, like, for nearly, like, 2 decades. They have 3 daughters together, but for the past, like, couple of years, there's been problems in the marriage. He's been spending a lot more time at work, and he just hasn't been paying her much attention at all. Something ends up happening with the ex-husband, and things kind of come out about him. And I don't know if I can say, can I say what it happened in the first like 50 pages, but kind of something happens, and Judah's job is like a forensic something or other, and he like takes down people. So his job is to dig down Soledad's husband. Now it is like a forbidden romance situation, because he's literally taking down her husband, and it's a romance between Judah and Soledad. Now, Judah is a single dad to his two sons. Now, him and his wife had a divorce like 3 years ago, and his twin boys are actually autistic. So both of them are on the autistic spectrum. There's that representation. Judah and Soledad actually meet at a Christmas party, and they kind of instantly have this like attraction towards each other. Like, Soledad isn't so attracted towards him, but I said she's married, so she won't do anything about it. And then Judah, you don't get that in his point of view, but you can tell that he's like attracted towards her. Judah, I feel like what's going to happen is he just ends up helping Soledad out and her daughters out as well with everything that's going on with the husband. So I've only read 60 pages, so I can't really say too much. I'm trying to do this without giving spoilers, even though it's only 60 pages in. I still don't want to say because it isn't technically like on the back of the book, like it's not on the blurb. But so far, I'm really enjoying it. I don't know what it is about Kennedy Ryan, but she just hits every time I read her books. I love Before I Let Go, and just her writing is just so, like, it just draws you in. And I just love her characters, and I love how, like, realistic her characters are. Like, reading about characters just feels like you're reading about actual, like, real people, which I love in books. That's why I love, like, the Boys Tommy series so much, because just following their lives. This book is just going to be her trying to find herself, as well as you have like the romance. But what I love about Kennedy Ryan's books is you have the romance, but then you also have the characters finding themselves and great character development. So I'm excited to carry it on. That's just it for right now. And yeah, I'll update you guys later on when I read more of my book. Hi guys, so it's currently the next day, it's currently Saturday, and I thought I'd give you an update on my book. I've read another about like 75 pages of it, so I'm on page 136, and so far I'm still absolutely loving this book. There's not really too much of a plot, like it is Soledad trying to find herself after what happened with her marriage, so you kind of get this in like several parts. Well, I'm currently at part two, so I'm guessing there's gonna be more parts. You have part one, and then part two that I'm in is set like 8 months later, and it's literally Soledad trying to find herself, being single for the first time in like her whole life, near enough, because she was married for nearly 2 decades. So you kind of have that, as well as trying to become a single parent as well. And then we have Jonah, who is trying to help Soledad out. He is the one who was told to kind of bring down Soledad's... Is this moving? I'm so sorry if this is moving. There we go. Jonah's job was trying to bring down Soledad's husband, who is a horrible guy, but then at the same time, like, he wants to care for Soledad, try to be there for her as well, because everything that she's going through. I love both Jonah and Soledad. I love them both as characters. I think Soledad is just such a strong female character, and she is such an amazing mother, and Jonah is an amazing father as well, and they're both single parents, so it's like single parent trope, but we're both of them single parents. What I love about Jonah as well is how healthy the co-parenting relationship is with him and his ex-wife, because I know sometimes with like single parent tropes, the other parent is not in the life, or it's very toxic, and I know that is kind of realistic, but at the same time, I love reading about books where the co-parenting is just so healthy, and those is, which I really like reading about. Probably about like 40% of the way through this book. I'm going to try to read it all today. I'm not sure if I will, because I'm kind of reading a little bit slowly. I don't know why. I just want to take in the information, and I'm annotating it as well, and just seeing my like cute quotes through. So yeah, I'm really enjoying it. I hope this book is a very much of a slow book, which I think it will be because of the situation that both characters are in. So I'm intrigued to carry on, and I'll update you guys later on. Hi guys, so it's quite a little bit later on now. It's currently about like 8 o'clock. Whenever I show the book I'm reading, just affects lighting. Also, my foot hurts because I literally just dropped my laptop on my foot, which is very stupid. I thought I'd give you an update of This Could Be Yours. My opinion is still the same as last time, in the sense I'm really enjoying this book. I feel like it's going to be like a solid 4 to a 4.25 stars. I really do like the character. I like that it's a slow burn. They have like kissed once, but Soledad is still not ready to kind of be in a relationship. And Judah's just like, I'll wait for you, which I don't know why, whenever the phrase like I'll wait for you comes up in a book, I swoon every single time. And I just love reading about the characters' like day-to-day lives, and even though you still get a lot of romance in this, I just love reading about Soledad and her character development and her focusing on herself and doing things that she loves. The amount of quotes in this book that I've highlighted and tabbed, there is a lot. So yeah, I'm really enjoying it. I'm going to finish the last like 140 pages tonight, and I'll probably give you like my final thoughts tomorrow, because when I finish this book, it'll be a lot later on, And I'll probably be too tired to film, so I'll probably update you guys tomorrow when I finish it and then start my other book, which I think is like Mr. Hockey, whatever it's called. Hi guys, so it's currently the next day. It's quite a little bit later on, so ignore if the lighting's a little bit dark. I've literally been busy all day. I've read a bit of my book and then I also have been deep cleaning my room all day. I'm trying to organise like my clothes, my beauty products, my makeup, all that type of thing. I've got like a massive pile of clothes down next to me because they need to go in my bedroom, but then I forgot to buy hangers when I bought a new clothing rail because I'm so stupid. But I did finish this Queer Yours yesterday and I have started Mr. Hockey today. I ended up giving this book a 4-star. I really, really loved it. I kind of thought going into it that it would be at least like a 4.25, 4.5 star. I definitely say I prefer Before I Let Go because that book had more of like the emotional factor into it. I would definitely say this is more of like women's fiction than romance. So you do get quite a bit of romance into it. But I would say it is more about Soledad finding herself becoming more independent after her divorce. I'd definitely say that is majority of the plot. And then you have Judah and living his life. And it is more of like a Judah saying to Soledad, like, I'm going to wait for you. Like, whenever you're ready, I'm here type of thing. Then you have a lot of like development in the romance. I don't know if that makes any sense, but I still did really enjoy it. And I gave it 4, so it was still a very good read. And then I have read 100 pages of Mr. Hockey. This book is only just less than 200 pages, so I'm already halfway through. It's more of like a novella length, I would say. This one follows Jed and what is the girl's name? Her name's Breezy, but it's not her actual name. I don't know, is it like Brianna or something is actually her name? But everyone just calls her Breezy. Breezy has always had this like massive crush on Jed, who is in the NHL. She actually has drawings of him. She has like a life-size cardboard cutout of him as well. Like, she is obsessed with him. And her sister actually works for the hockey team. Breezy needs like a special guest to go ahead and like read to the kids because she works at this like library. So then Jed kind of offers about doing this and that's kind of how they meet. Now, my thoughts on this book so far is it's just hella cringy. Like, it's just hella cringy. I kind of knew it would be because whenever like a girl is obsessed with a guy, I'm like, this book is going to cringe me out. Literally 11 pages in. You know what? I'm going to read this to you because it's not a spoiler. She calls him Westy. Because her name's Jed West, which is just cringy itself. Westy was the carrot to her peas, the cheese to her macaroni, the gin to her tonic, the corned beef to her cabbage. Like, what is going on? Like, I don't know what is going on there, but it's just, there's a lot of cringy things happening in this book. It's quite spicy as well. Like, it's not PG, let's just say. Yeah, I don't know. I really don't know what I'm reading right now. I can understand the 3.3 something rating for this book. I'm going to read the last 100 pages soon and then I'll give you my final like thoughts on it because I can't really give you many updates considering this book is only 200 pages, but I'll let you know when I finish it and my thoughts. If I wasn't filming this video, I probably would have DNF'd it after that quote 11 pages in. Like, I read that quote and I was like, I'd DNF it if I wasn't filming this video, but I need to finish it. So I'll finish it and then I'll let you guys know my final thoughts later on. Hi guys, so it's quite a little bit later on now. It's currently about like 9:30 and I've just finished Mr. Hockey. And overall, I thought it was a fun read. Was it like the highest rated book I've read? No, I ended up giving it a 2.75 stars because this book is literally like novella length. Like, it's just under 200 pages. The other two books in the series are like 150 pages, so they're all very short reads. But I just thought it was fun. I wasn't bored. Was it cringy at times? Yes. You can't have like a full-on connection to both characters and together because throughout this book, I feel like the characters only knew each other for like a week or so. They did tell each other that they were in love with each other and I was a bit like, you've known each other for a week. Like, I hate when that happens in books when they kind of tell each other they love each other that quickly. I feel like I might actually read the other books in the series because the next book is called Head Coach, which is about the coach of the hockey team. And his book is with Neve, who is Breezy's sister. Now, what I liked about this book as well is you kind of go into both characters and what they're dealing with. So, Breezy's always kind of felt like that she's not good enough. Her ex broke up with her and quickly got married to someone else. Her mum's always kind of preferred Neve over her. And then we have Jed, who He's kind of dealing a lot with an injury in hockey, so you don't really get a lot of hockey in this book. You have a lot of talk of hockey, but you don't actually have any like hockey in the book, and other things that are going on in his life with his family, so you kind of get that. There was a third situation, well, there's a third like breakup, which I just found like was very unnecessary. I feel like if a book is this short, and I feel like with all like novellas and just short books, there should be a third breakup, because why, when it's literally 200 pages? But I still thought it was fun. I don't know if I'm going to put it as like a 2 or 3 on Goodreads, because it's like a 2.75, but then it's a lower rated book than the books I've put on like 3 stars on Goodreads, if that makes any sense. So I'm not sure what I'm going to put on Goodreads, but a 2.75 star. It was overall fun. I wasn't bored. I got through it quickly. But yeah, overall had a really fun time with this. I might actually do this video in like a few months' time, so let me know if you do want to see this video again. But if you did enjoy this video, as always, if you haven't already, please subscribe button and like this video, and I'll see you guys in a brand new video. Bye!